I finally finished all of the Halloween candy from last year. Last night, I think. This is why no human being should go to bed at 7:45. It's 11:58 and I'm raiding the closet. Oh, for God's sake. Excuse me, I want to get a snack. No, not happening. Get off the counter. What the hell are you doing? Incredibly rude. I don't come in and walk all over your counters. I mean, really. You asshole. I swear to God. It's that damn closet again. Full of goodies. Today's special treat, Nutter Butters. Hey, that looks kind of cool. That would be a cool diamond painting. Let's take a picture. Isn't he adorable?
I got a little surprise delivery today. I want to see what it is. Let me try and get this set up so I can record it. There we go. Oh, what is this? Diamond grinder. It's a diamond grinder. Oh, look at this. I don't have one. I was thinking, you know, ball peen hammer. Goggles. Oh my God, I didn't know they made one specifically. I know people have been using pill crushers, but I didn't know they made one just for diamonds. Here, let me pick you up so you can see the instructions here. This diamond separator is provided as is, Archer Arts. It's Associates. I need to set this down because I'm shaking all over the place. Archer Arts is Associates or signs make no warranty of any kind. Okay. Overfilling the separator with resin. The following uses may cause irreparable damage to the diamond separator. Overfilling the separator with resins, pressing down hard or firmly when the separator is filled with resins, roughly twisting the separator when attempting to separate the resins. The diamond separator is best suited for square-shaped resins. The separator will work with round-shaped resins, but the resins may not be the same. Ooh. That's cool. I had no idea anybody made one. Pour them into the grinder tray, shake into the grooves, place the grinder lid over the diamonds. Gently twist until diamonds are separated. Oh, I can't wait to try this. I have a few colors, especially on the paint with diamonds, that are really bad. I'm looking forward to trying it out. Lovely surprise, cute little bag with a thank you note. That is awesome. And the color, of course, perfect. And the mailer, of course, perfect. Thank you very much. Really appreciate that. So that was just really quick. Wanted to get this on recorded so that I could put it in with one of the upcoming videos, because I'm again behind, but getting there. We'll have a tour later, but it is, let's see, Saturday night, 8 o'clock, and time for bed. I had a rough one today. You'll hear about it later. I've never gotten this close to one. Watch this.
Hi, little guy.
Ooh.
Run, run. Hello.
Where are you? Where'd he go? There he is.
Jump, baby, jump.
Brian washed the patio. Looks awesome. Okay, back to work. What is that flying around? Hey, Allison. I've got gnats in my house. They're driving me crazy. Yesterday, when I was taking calls, I had one that kept landing on my lips. I thought any moment it's gonna go right in my mouth. They're everywhere. It's disgusting. And it is now officially dark out when I get up in the morning because we're losing sunlight. So I have to use my light on my phone. It is 7:03 a.m. on Wednesday, October 17th, and it's time to get up. Yeah, that's got to be a gnat flying around. Okay.
Time to get up. Oh, my goodness.
Oh. You know, the whole idea that these little bugs came in our painting box. Freaks the shit out of me. Okay, you don't need to. Okay. Let's do this thing. Okay. Hang on. Okay.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, I have a dilemma. I like the little kitschy names for the videos on the different days of the week. Love it. And it was suggested to me that it would be Wendy's What Not to Do. And you can throw that on a Wednesday. Love it. However, I think my microphone keeps rubbing my shirt there. I gotta hold it up. Wendy's What Not to Do Wednesday. Today's Wednesday. But I already have a video scheduled to go out today. So this won't go out till Thursday. For Thursday, hold on, I got a cough. There I go. Thursday, I just had it when I was upstairs and I forgot. I think it was something like Thoughtful Thursdays and doing like would you rather questions or tags. Tag Tuesday, obviously. But my dilemma, because, you know, because I gotta overthink everything, is do I name it for the day I'm recording it? Because today's a Wednesday. Or do I name it for the day it's getting posted? Something's crawling on my toes. Ew. Maybe it's my imagination. Wig out Wednesday? Oh, look, I didn't even have to do the dart. She just saw me stir my coffee. It's progressing. Okay, let's use just voice commands. Spin. Spin. Roll over. High five. See, she has no clue. You gotta do that. Put on too many clothes. I was feeling like, you know, with it being dark, it was going to be like a nice cool morning. And I put on, I'm going to do this with my foot. I'm going to do it. I got to set something down. Oh yeah, I got on too many clothes. I was thinking I'd be able to wear leggings today. Oh, so, no, I'm roasting. It's... yeah, it's a high 70s. A little warm for wearing leggings. Oh boy. It's because our bedroom is freezing. Woke up thinking, oh, it's nice, brisk. Got a cough. Okay. God, I keep clearing my throat. Let's see, how's that looking? That looks okay. Put you in the coaster tray. Worked perfectly. Oh, here comes some more of those condors or vultures or pterodactyls. I can't even see them. They're in invisibility mode. Brian, yesterday, tested out his, well, actually for the last couple days, he's been testing out his machine. He washed our roof. I have not gone out there and looked at it yet, but I'm guessing it's gorgeous. A lot of, oh, God. All right, I need to drink a little of my coffee. Don't drink that water. It's got bleach in it. Do you see what I see in the pool? There's a submarine. Is that an alligator? Oh, it's a bubble. Why do I have a soap bubble in the pool? That's weird. Alright. Oops, sorry, loud. Let's see. I had it so nicely before that. There we go. Oh, that's lovely. Oh, sorry. Keep clearing my throat. Just woke up. Oh God, what the hell was I talking about? Oh, he washed the roof. And down here, the black mildew, mold, whatever the hell it's growing on the roofs, gets really bad. So I'm excited to see what ours looks like. Maybe we'll take a venture out there later. And then he also, I don't need my reading glasses on. He also washed down the patio and the lanai and the screens and all of that yesterday. Did all the patio furniture. And it's really clean. So I was about to light a second cigarette and I haven't even smoked the first one. So I'm gonna brag later, give you a little tour of that. Oh, here's the condors. There they go. He said he also had a huge frog on the screen the other morning. He said it was like when he held up his hands. Let's see, what can I think of that's the right size? Because you can't see perspective and proportion on here. Well, he held up his hands and, you know, this is like a standard coaster. It was like an extra inch in diameter, bigger than a regular coaster, around this frog hanging off a screen. And yesterday, when we were putting back all the patio furniture, all the little lizards, the little baby lizards all over the place, they were traumatized. With all the getting blasted, I'm sure, with the
with the pressure washer, and some of them ended up in the house, and we were trying to catch them all and release them back to freedom. Oh, there's activity going on. Let's see what she's gonna do. Here he comes. Hey.
Hi.
Oh my God. Just so you know, I'm recording.
I'm going to need you to just proof this real quick. You don't have to change anything. Just look
sure.
it over.
Yeah, that's fine. I was telling them about the frog you saw on the screen. I said I thought it was about an inch bigger than a coaster.
Yeah.
About the, yeah, an extra inch
that's
wide.
About right.
But it was dark out, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then our adventures in catching the lizards yesterday after we were putting the furniture back and Jesse having to chase them around the kitchen.
Yeah, I think the lizards took a hit.
Took a little bit of a hit.
Yeah.
It was no longer Shangri-La back here.
No, it's like, the population has decreased. But there's still a lot of them on the screens.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They're still all...
Yeah, we started with two.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But those poor, I felt bad, but they're everywhere. And then you start spraying and they crawl out behind stuff and you don't realize there's, I mean, I was trying to avoid them, but there was nothing.
They were blowing all over the place, huh?
Well, yeah. And then I come down off the ladder and I'd see them still struggling on the ground.
Well, I was going to say there was definitely something wrong if I could actually go up and pet one and it didn't move because
yeah.
he was traumatized.
Yeah. But I think... they'll come back.
I don't want them coming back. I want them outside.
I think they keep the bugs away from the house.
The screen does that.
Well, so do the lizards. And I think the lizards are... I'd rather have the lizards than the bugs.
Okay. I wonder if they could be like...
Can you give me the
action? Yeah, I wonder if they could be like squirrels, where you could actually like hand feed them, train them.
My wife, the crazy squirrel lady.
Hey. They're cute.
You're, yeah.
I'm what?
You're the crazy squirrel lady.
Okay. So what's your plan today?
I got stuff to do this morning, calling, whatever, and then I got that meeting at 11, I think, with those CEOs,
mm-hmm.
and then afterwards I'm going to come back and either work on office stuff yet or start cleaning the siding a little bit more.
Finish the balcony?
Or finish the balcony, yeah. I mean, there's still a good day for me to clean the whole thing yet, so...
Mm-hmm. Apparently, this is the migratory time at 7:30. They're just flying all over. It's like they've got a plot. They're all...
They're following the garbage trucks right now.
Is that what they're doing?
Probably.
Yesterday, when I went out front to have a cigarette, when you were washing the back, there was two of them standing on our sidewalk right out the front door, 4 feet out, and they... just kind of stood there staring at me while I was smoking.
Yeah.
I was like, and they're close. Jasmine. She just stares at you constantly.
Uh-huh. She probably appreciates the clean patio more than us.
Probably. You know how the animals are. Because what do you say about when the grass is cut?
What about it?
Who likes it most?
Well, she likes it.
I thought it was the squirrels appreciate it when the grass is cut.
Oh, yeah, because then they... Yeah.
They can find their nuts easier, right?
Hey, you're trying too hard now.
Shut up. So critical.
Overactor.
I'm not acting.
Okay.
I'm really like this.
Where's my wife?
Shut up. You said you lost her at the altar. I changed immediately. All right, have a good one.
Okay. I'm going to need you to prep that probably 5 minutes.
All right, I'm going to finish my coffee.
I mean, I'm just saying it'll only take 5 minutes.
Oh, I thought you said in 5 minutes. Okay. He's getting more and more used to me just filming all the time. So, see, I just announced that I'm recording. I think part of that is because he and I have so many conversations that are freaking hysterical. And then I'll throw out the comment, oh man, I wish I was recording that. I think he's finding... Oh, there's a tiny little frog. All right, it's Wildlife Wednesday. Oh! Did you see him before he jumped? Where is he? Oh, there he is. Let me zoom in. Let's go out here. Sorry, I'm dealing with the... Here we go. Okay. Now, you need perspective. Here's my finger. I can't, I'm gonna stand in the dirt. All right, hold on, sorry. Okay. So you can see how big he is. Let me find him again. That's my finger. Oh, tiny little thing. Now my foot's dirty. And the patio's clean. So here's the clean patio. I don't know if you remember, there was that huge stain right there. So he got rid of that. And it looks like there's still something there, but it's actually, this is paint. So the paint is already worn off there. But look at how clean it is. So clean. And then there's this thing up here. I didn't know what that was. I was thinking, I wonder if that's a snail. Let's zoom in. I don't know what that is. Maybe it's an acorn. I don't know. A leaf, whatever. But yeah, he cleaned all this. So it's like sparkly clean. He even cleaned the grill. All the furniture. I don't know. I'm sure you've seen it a few times where it's like black, gross. This stuff's horribly faded. See, it's supposed to be navy blue, but that's whatever fabric we bought those from. That fades, but these didn't. These didn't fade. So live and learn. Next time we'll get something that doesn't fade so bad. Let's see, what else can I show you? Wildlife Wednesday. Here's a lizard. Let's go see another lizard. finger. Ooh. Oh, and Jesse and I each got bit by one yesterday, picking them up. But it startled us more so than anything, because I don't think they have teeth. But yeah, we each took a hit in trying to provide our relocation services. I don't know if there's any other wildlife out here right now. Oh, there's one. The rare beast. Alrighty. Well, that was an adventure. So we got to see the sandhill cranes. We got to see the little tiny frog. We got to see the little lizard. I don't know exactly what kind of lizards those are. What are they called? I don't know. Somebody will know. Somebody's going to tell me. Where's my microphone? I think it's rubbing on my neck. I'm sorry. I'm going to just unplug. The earbud microphones are fantastic for getting the good volume that doesn't go up and down, but I have to be more prepared in that I've noticed that if it rubs against, you know, my clothes or my neck or anything else, it's very distracting. So I need to like clip it in place so that it's hanging between my neck and my collarbone without touching anything, so that I don't have all that interference. And I just threw it on this morning. So that's that. Wildlife Wednesday. And then we've got Thoughtful Thursday. And Work with Wendy Wednesday. Work from Home Wednesday. Thoughtful Thursday. Tag Tuesday. All kinds of ideas. So I'm just gonna, you know, randomly throw those titles out on any given day of the week. And whatever day I recorded, I just throw you for a loop. Unpredictable. All right. Ooh, God, that's loud. Sorry. It's almost 8. I need to change my clothes because this is way too warm. It's always very warm up there until, like, I don't know, mid to late afternoon, and then it starts getting chilly. So I need to go change because this is way too warm for me. And it's 7:45. I need to be on the phone at 8:30. And I want to get Alice set up so I can diamond paint today in between calls. So let me kind of do what I can. Alright, I'm gonna chug this and make another cup. Yeah, so it, I don't know what the deal is with the gnats, but I cleaned the kitchen. An overhaul the other day, and gnats everywhere. Yuck. So yeah, that really, they better not be coming in the boxes from the diamond paintings, because I didn't throw away anything, because I can't. Okay. All right. Work in progress Wednesday. Wendy's work in progress. Here's where I'm at with Alice. And yeah, I've got the tilt top table from Chanda in the living room, because
This is where I've been working on it, so let's see where we are. Let me turn on the light here. How do I do that? Well, I'm already recording. If I poke it, no, that's not what I want to do. Let's see. Camera. Oh, that's not right. I don't know how you do it once you're already recording, but anyway. Oh. Okay, so you can kind of see how far I got. I'm getting to her eyes. Can't wait. But yeah, so I've got, and then down to about there. Oh yeah, so you can see where I've landed. But I want to take her. I want to take her upstairs. Okay, I'm gonna do this in stages because I only have one hand. So we'll start with her and this. Let's see how many times she follows me up and down the stairs over and over again. Okay. Here's the quick tour of the mess. I was talking to Danette yesterday and I showed her how I have it set up for, hang on, I'll clean this up real quick. Plus, all right, so this is my work computer, keyboard and mouse for the work computer, and a notepad, coffee warmer, and cold beverages. So here's my, and what time is it? Calculator, all that. Then for my personal, I've got my dual monitors so I can work on stuff during the day. And of course my chargers for, you know, old and new Android chargers, phone and tablet. And then I've got some job aids back there. And then this. Okay. So I knew I'd come up with something to use it for. This is the oven liner, and I have one of them over here for my stickers. Okay, here's my other oven liner. So it's just clipped to my thing, rolled up. Job aids, scripts for calls, extensions I need. The ready at hand stuff, because I gotta read the same scripts over and over and over again. And for the most part, you have them committed to memory, but there you go. But I don't want to look at that all the time. So just roll it up. Awesome. Okay. Now, oh, so Danette was saying, I thought you were gonna set this up so that you could diamond paint, because I had crap everywhere. But all I have to do is just slide it over a little, and I'll show you. Hold on. Look, I've got all that space. So that's what I want to do, is get Alice set up. And I need to hurry because it's almost time. So I'm not going to try and do this one-handed with you guys. I'm just going to do it. Okay. See you in a minute. All right, it is scramble time. I need a couple things. I need my power cord for my light pad. My husband wired up the living room. Every couch has a power strip under it. Because we live in an electronic age. Alright, so I got that. And then, one more quick break. It's like 8:13.
Okay. Oh boy.
I did proofread his thing. He writes in Yoda speak, where the sentence structure's all flipped around on you. Yesterday on the phones was awesome. It was really good. As far as the breaks and stuff and not being overwhelmed, bombarded. But I did have one person who was very unhappy and did my best. But she was having none of it. She was very upset. So I got chewed out. It was all, at least it was very brief. It was a 3-minute call for me to get my ass handed to me, but I tried very desperately to get through and try and help her. I don't have a lot to say, so I guess I'm gonna just stop it here and we'll pick up later. Here's what we're gonna try today. Work from home Wednesday. Now, of course, I can't show my screens. And this is going to be a voiceover for something else. Probably the book. Because you can't listen to my calls either. So, it'll be a time lapse of me. We'll see how long we go. I don't know how much memory I have on my phone. But we'll record as much of my day as we can. And then I'll time lapse for it. So, it is 8:27, time for me to log in, get all prepared. Got Alice here. Okay, so I am recording on Thursday morning to go over the top of Wednesday morning. Get to know me YouTube tab. So, I'm doing this while I'm just getting ready for my day. First question on the tag is, what is your middle name? I think I already answered some of these, and I apologize if I did. My middle name is Brooke. Yes, I know I've answered this. It was my grandmother's maiden name, Brooks. Share your favorite subject in high school. Math. Algebra specifically. What is your favorite drink? I've got a few. I like the one that my husband and I kind of concocted after our honeymoon. We called it Test Drive is what we named it. But the story behind it is that for our honeymoon, he wanted to just have no destination. Just get in the car and go wherever we wanted for 2 weeks. And I'm a planner. I like hotel reservations. I like dinner reservations. I like reservations. And I didn't like the idea. So he said, well, let's try it out for a long weekend ahead of time. See how it goes. Oops, excuse me. So I agreed. And while we were on this test drive honeymoon, we ate at this roadside, roadhouse restaurant, and they had a specialty drink called Route 66 because the restaurant was on historic Route 66. And essentially what it is cherry Dr. McGillicuddy's with, what's in it, pineapple juice and Sierra Mist. And the shit tastes just like Hawaiian Punch. Great. So I like that. And I also like margaritas on the rocks with salt. I like me a good Long Island iced tea, but it's been a while. And it's non-alcoholic cherry Coke. That's enough. That's enough beverages. And let's see here. What is your favorite song at the moment? Oh, gosh. I don't know. I don't have a favorite. I do really like the... Over the Rainbow, the ukulele version. I like that. And, well, basically, I don't know, anything that strikes my mood. I do try and put a lot of different little sound clips of music into my videos. Whatever I can snag that's, you know, not gonna give me a copyright strike against me. And so far I've been really lucky that anything that is copyrighted is able to be used. But I, right now, my all-time favorite group would be Queen. Love it. It's the CD in my car. It's their movie's coming out soon, and I'm excited for that big time. Cannot wait to see that. But yeah, I like Queen. Sorry, I'm making the bed while I'm doing this, so I don't see my questions. They're not near me. Let me get back over there and do it. And here's the heavy breathing again because I'm in motion. Okay. The next question I've already answered. Number six is, have you participated in any sports? No. Not like on a team or anything. The only thing even remotely close that I ever participated in, I didn't even officially participate, as horseback riding. I took horseback riding lessons for several years. I think I started when I was probably in maybe second grade, I'm guessing, probably. Second grade is when I started, and I continued taking lessons until probably, I don't know, maybe 7th or 8th grade, I think. We had horses. That was my mom's dream as a child, to own horses. And so my dad, we had 7 acres. And so he built a horse barn for her. And we got a couple of horses, and then our next door neighbors, they were my dad's, his first cousin and his family, and they ended up getting horses. I think we had one that they owned together, a mare, and well, I guess we started with one horse. Then they got Juliet. We had Ethan. And then they bought Juliet with his cousin, and they had her bred, and we got the first foal, which my mom named Prophet. And this is turning into a really long story about if I've had sports, turned sports. Anyway, so they had Prophet, and then they ended up building a huge stable, a boarding stable, and went into business next door. But since we had horses, you know, it just came naturally when you, they ended up boarding the horses, and I think free riding lessons if you board your horse. So I did that for a long time. And they were Morgan horses. Prophet ended up being like a really good, I don't know what they're called, the ones that pull the little cart with the one man in it. He ended up going... They sold him, and he ended up competing in that. And Ethan, I think, became one of the ones that would compete for pulling logs or some shit. I don't know. But we only had the horses for a few years. It became way too much work. You have to go out there, you know, all winter long and break the ice in their water buckets and feed them and all that stuff and clean the stalls. And so we had them for several years, but it just became too much work for my mom. She was the one who basically did most of the work because it was her little dream. So, but I did spend lots of summers. We had a John Deere lawn tractor with the wagon and a pasture that was, my dad put a fence around like half the yard. So probably a 3-acre pasture, and I would have to go out there with a pitchfork and pick up the poop, put it in the wagon, and then across the street we had a big vacant lot where we would dump it, and I would get in trouble with my best friend Anne. She would help me, and by help I mean laugh at me. She'd sit on the seat on the lawnmower and laugh at me picking up the poop. And we had a cattle gate across our driveway. We had big like brick kind of walls that were like in a horseshoe shape at the end of the driveway, and then my dad had built a pit, probably 3 feet deep pit, the width of the driveway, and then probably, I don't know, 10 feet the length, so it was like 10 by 12, and then it was 3 feet deep, and then there was this cattle gate across it. If you don't know what a cattle gate is, it was big hollow metal pipes that ran the width of the driveway, and then the pipes were separated by probably, oh, I don't know, two-inch gaps in between that would be the dead drop into this pit. And that was, the intention was to keep the animals in the yard, that they wouldn't be able to escape if, you know, we had German shepherds, to keep them, so that the idea, fenced in yard, they could just run loose and not be able to get out. But they always found a hole in the fence, and they could easily walk across the cattle gate, so that didn't work. And apparently that all was done before I was old enough to remember, because I don't remember ever having the dogs loose. So that was all tried out before I was probably even walking or speaking. So with the riding lessons, my instructor had, you know, encouraged me several times to start going to horse shows and competing, and I was way too shy, and huge fear of failure and being laughed at or falling off the horse or whatever. There was no way I was brave enough to ride in public, much less for competition against other people. So I never actually did it, but that's the closest I ever came to a sport. So that was a really long, drawn-out answer. Holy cow. All right, the next question. Let's see here. What is your favorite book? Oh gosh. I really enjoyed the Hunger Games series. I also really enjoyed Water for Elephants. Gosh, you know, I need to go look at my books and see. False Memory, Dean Koontz. I loved that book. Let's see. I can't pick a favorite. I've never read a book twice. Let's see here. What else have I read? See, I got rid of most of my books when we moved. Everything I'd already read, I dumped, which really ticks me off. I think I thought I kept all this Stephen King and Dean Koontz, but apparently not, because I don't see any of them here. So apparently I dumped them, which makes me sad. My favorite author is Dean Koontz. Second favorite, probably Stephen King. I did enjoy, yeah, I don't have Water for Elephants or any of that stuff anymore, so I must have gotten rid of it all. Darn it. Yeah. But yeah, Water for Elephants, and then there was, let's see. I haven't read a lot of authors other than Stephen King and Dean Koontz, but yeah, False Memory, probably. The Twilight series I enjoyed. 50 Shades of Grey series I enjoyed. But my favorites are Dean Koontz. Okay. Favorite color? Plum. Deep plum. After that, I do like this teal that my room is painted here. I like dark blue. I like like a wine red, a blood red. So basically the real deep, moody colors. And some of these I know I've, okay, I know I've already talked about my favorite perfume, I think. No, maybe I didn't. My favorite perfume has been discontinued. And my mother-in-law found it at Walgreens, apparently. She bought the last two that they had. Oh, I guess I am out of it. Darn. Shoot, now what the hell was the name of it? Darn, I can't remember. But yeah, apparently I'm out. So I can't even tell you what the name of it was anymore. How sad is that? If I think of it, I'll throw it in some other time. Yeah, I can't remember. They did the same thing with my favorite body wash and scent from Bed Bath & Beyond, which is the... shit, I just threw that one away too. Something amber. Sensual amber. Love that one too. They discontinued it. So again, my mother-in-law grabs up everything she can so that each year she'll give me one for Christmas. But yeah, so those two are gone. Gosh, I wish I could remember the name of the perfume. We did end up finding it at one of those little kiosks in the mall. And he said, yeah, it's not really discontinued. You can still get it. So maybe just Walgreens discontinued carrying it. I don't know. Favorite holiday, Halloween. Big time. Love it. Love it. I love dressing up. I love the whole thing. Sometimes I had to like beg the kids to go trick-or-treating with me just so I could dress up. I dress up at work. When I worked at the bank, they didn't dress up when I first started working there. So my first year there, I started in November. So then the following October, I asked the president of the company if we could dress for Halloween. And he's like, sure, why not? And then it became this huge deal over the years. I was there 10 years. By the time I left, they had cube decorating contests and costume contests and games and all kinds of stuff. By the end, Halloween became a big deal. And they had been in business for several years before I started working there, and it apparently never occurred to anybody to do anything for Halloween. So I take a little tiny snippet of credit for starting that there. And at my new company, yes, they already dress and everything, so that's great. But now I'm working from home, so I'll probably still dress even though I'm at home. And I won't tell my husband I'm going to dress. I'll just come down for, you know, my morning cup of coffee in costume. I mean, why not? So, second in line would be Christmas. Love decorating for Christmas, but we sold all that when we moved. So we're starting over, which is kind of cool because most of my decorations are like 20 years old and kind of falling apart and crappy. So now, you know, we're buying like nice decorations, more expensive stuff that, you know, higher end, but not as much. And then once we're able to, you know, we'll start adding into the collection and hopefully doing it the smart way by buying everything after Christmas for the next year, because that's the way to go. All right, and let's see here. On a scale of 1 to 10, rate your childhood. Oh, gosh. I was kind of a miserable child in that, you know, shy and no self-confidence, all that stuff. I had, you know, I don't know. I think I made it more miserable on myself than it really was because I was just an unhappy person. I probably had, you know, depression back then and didn't realize what was going on. But anyway, from my perspective, my childhood, I would rate it probably a 6. If I compare my childhood to other people, you know, thinking specifically of the less fortunate, I probably had a 10. If I look at my childhood from my parents' perspective, they would probably give it a 9. From my friend's perspective, looking in from the outside, they probably would have rated it a 10. It always looks better from the outside than what it is in your head, I think. You know, I guess maybe that's why I've kind of got this idea in my head about I would rather be happy than rich, because we were well off when I grew up in comparison to a lot of my friends. And so, you know, I had the nice clothes and the big yard and the, you know, the brick home and all that stuff. And I had horses and all of that. And from their perspective of living in these, you know, little like 1,000 square foot homes that had 4 bedrooms, and they converted the garage into a bedroom because they didn't have enough, you know, those were my friends. They had these little tiny houses that were crammed full of stuff to fit all the people. And then they see me living in that house, and to them, I'm sure it seemed like, ooh, you know. But they were the ones who got to go to Santa's Village and to Great America and to the carnival and to, you know, the county fair and all that stuff. And we didn't do any of that as a family because Dad was always working, and my mom was pretty much exactly like I am now. She was a loner. She liked to do solitary things. She liked to read. She, you know, just was an introvert big time. And she didn't spend time playing with us as kids. We were kind of left to our own devices to entertain ourselves and be quiet, because she's, you know, watching her soap opera. So there wasn't a lot of, you know, nurturing going on. Dad was never home because he was working, because somebody's got to pay for all this stuff. And Mom was doing her own thing, and we needed to be quiet. So, yeah, I didn't enjoy my childhood. It got better once we had the cousins move in next door, and they had 2 daughters that were, one of them was about a year younger than me, and the other one was like 3 years younger than me. So then I had somebody to play with. But we lived on the outskirts of town. We weren't close enough to any neighborhoods for me to be able to just go over and play with other kids. So there was nobody around. And my cousins, the 2 girls I played with, their mother was a raving bitch. So I would go to their house to play all the time because they had like a huge toy room. And we could make a giant mess, but their mom was a raving bitch, and she would scream at us, you know, and just, So it wasn't the best either that way. So we ended up playing in the summer. We'd play outside all the time. But yeah, their mom was just hell on wheels. It got to the point when we were adults that there was such a feud going on between our family and their family that, like, my mom put up a lattice wall across her patio so that the bitch couldn't sit there and stare at her. She'd sit in a chair on the hill with her binoculars and watch my mom in the yard, and then sit on the phone and tell people what she was doing. I mean, she was just nuts. And then and another point later on, my brother got in a fist fight with the husband, my dad's cousin. I mean, it was nasty shit, you know, going on between the two families. So not good. And that was all while I was, it started while I was in high school. Well, actually, it started when my dad left. He left my mom, and once he was out of the house, then all hell broke loose, and they kind of unleashed on us, because my dad was kind of the one who always was present to keep it from exploding. But once he had moved out, then, yeah, it got really nasty. So, yeah, not the greatest childhood. But yeah, I mean, I did get to have horseback riding lessons. I had really nice clothes, that kind of stuff. I enjoyed the horseback riding lessons. I didn't enjoy the clothes. did not want to be dressed like that. I wanted to be dressed like all the other kids because I was like stood out big time. And when you're a kid, what do you want more than to fit in? So found out later on that all the other kids in school, not all, but a lot of them envied my clothes. But kids are nasty. So at the time they made fun of me, but I found out later on that they were actually jealous of my nice clothes and that's why they teased me. So anyway, yeah, not a happy kid. And I wasn't really a happy adult either until we got to Florida. Now I'm pretty freaking happy. Okay. Next question. Have you been out of the country? Yes. I've been to Puerto Vallarta and the Caribbean and Canada. And Canada was like 2 miles over the border. That's another long story. Oh, gosh. It's 8:14, so I only got a few minutes, but I'll tell as much of this story as I can. So I was on Match.com, and I had met somebody who was from Canada and really liked talking to him. Talked to him for a couple months. And eventually, we agreed to meet. So the halfway point was, because he, you know, he's in Canada. The halfway point ended up being just around Detroit, I think. But I had never been to Canada, so we decided to meet in Canada. So we met in Sarnia. And so I got to go to Sarnia. We met, had lunch together, went to a movie. We had adjoining rooms in a hotel. No, nothing happened. There was no chemistry from my side. He apparently felt that there was a lot of chemistry, but it was not mutual. We went to a movie, and during the entire movie, I could feel him and see him out of my peripheral vision. He was watching me, not the movie. It was so creepy. He would not, like, while we were eating, he didn't take his eyes off of me to look at his food, to pick it up on the fork. I mean, it was just creepy as hell. So, yeah, only met him once, but that was the end of that.
You are physically repulsive, intellectually retarded, you're morally reprehensible, vulgar, insensitive, selfish, stupid, you have no taste, a lousy sense of humor, and you smell.
Oh. Well, we have other uses for Loctite. All right, next up. Andrea Strom. Andrea Strom. Okay, Andrea is Clara City, Minnesota. She says, I want to see you do the mermaid first, not trying to be pushy, but hurry up and do that one. I don't have any wild stick out kind of facts, but I am a cat lady who has 5 Persians. I live in Clara City, Minnesota. Also, dude, no need to be self-conscious about your body. You're pretty. If anyone gives you crap, just kick them in the balls. All right, well. Okay. I think it might go without saying. I like Andrea. Andrea also is the one who helped me out with my phone issues with the SD card and told me what I needed to do. So, Clara City, Minnesota. I betcha it is kind of cold up there right about now. I know my relatives in Wisconsin, it's winter's coming. Okay, let's see where Clara City is. Near the Hinterland Vineyards. All right, and let's see. All right, so it is west of Minneapolis. And appears to be about 3/5 of the way straight across from Minneapolis before the state line in Minnesota. I don't have state lines, so we're going to just link it. Minneapolis, and I need to triangulate because I don't have Fargo, Minneapolis, and Sioux Falls. Okay, it's in between all those. Minneapolis, Fargo, Sioux Falls, Do do do. Right there. It looks like she's on the. Is that, that's longitude? 45th parallel? Is that right? Longitude and latitude?
Yeah.
All right, Andrea. All right, next we'll do, let's get out of the country for a little bit. Olivia Robinson. She goes by Ollie. She's from Mansfield, Nottinghamshire in the UK. Ollie, married 27 years, grandma, two sons, two grandsons, husky dog, Mansfield, Nottinghamshire, UK, middle of the UK map. Eldest grandson is over there in Orlando, Disney at the moment. Fell in love with diamond painting and diamond painting from Donnie and Ella. And apparently stumbled upon me. And so do very much appreciate it, Ollie. Okay, so I'm going to definitely have to Google this. Okay, so it appears to be, let's see, about 3/5 of the way between London and Liverpool, but then east of Leeds. Now, let's see how many of those are around here. Probably none of them. So I'm just going to head between London and Liverpool and scooch it up a little. Let's see here. London. Liverpool's not on here, of course. Birmingham. Where's Birmingham? It's nowhere. Nowhere to be found. Okay. Alright, we're going to have to go by geography, land. Okay, we got this little bay here. And it's like right here, it looks like. I don't know why I'm not finding where. Oh, pin broke. Oh, I broke the pin. I think that's good luck. There we go. I don't know why Birmingham doesn't show up on Google. Very odd. Okay. There we go. Ollie. Okay. And the last one for today. Dawn Lee. Dawn is from Wichita, Kansas. Hey Wendy, it's me, your favorite pest. Guess I should tell you a little about myself. As I said, I live in Wichita, Kansas. I was born and raised in Pennsylvania. I'm married, 60 years old. You know, I just by the way you talked on, I would have thought you were like 35, because you're such a sarcastic little booger sometimes, aren't you? Love it. Well, you certainly don't act like you're 60. That's a compliment. I'm married, 60 years old. I have two sons and two grandsons and three granddaughters. The most precious thing I have is my little Chihuahua Minpin, named Missy. Chihuahua Minpin named Missy. I have been diamond painting for nearly a year. I enjoy knitting, bead looming, cross stitch, and watching your silly self. You and Tiny just make my day, but Jasmine is my favorite. Thanks for brightening my days. You're the best. I'm a retired medical transcriptionist. Make sure that that's it. Yep, awesome. So, Dawn in Wichita, Kansas. I have not seen a lot of Dawn lately. She has been she's been commenting, but not nearly as much as she used to. So I hope everything's good, Dawn. Okay, triangulate between Oklahoma, Denver, and Kansas City. Okay. Oklahoma City, Kansas City, and Denver. Right in the middle. Oh, what the shit? It's right. It's actually on the map. Well, if I would have triangulated, I would have missed it. I don't know why I was thinking it was over there. But there's Dawn. All right. Okay, we are going to stop it there, and I will get some more done for the next video so that we can try and do this a little more often. Here's everybody. And white was today. One of these white ones was already on here, but we got 7 people on the map this time. So that's fantastic. And coming up next, coming up next is the end of the video because I made you watch the whole thing in order to get to this. So I don't know whether or not the one that you watched was any good because I haven't edited it yet. But it is, today is Monday, October 15th, and I'm still working on the stuff from last Monday because I did that thing where I take the camera around with me for the entire flipping day and end up with like 6 hours of recorded stuff and I can't seem to throw anything away. So if this is all new to you and you don't know what this is about, go I'll put it at the end, but I started a map of the subscribers to see where in the world everybody was, and if you want to be put on my map, you do not need to find the original video. All I need to know is your city, state, country, province, and whatever you'd like me to share with everybody about you. Because we've got to have something to go off of to remember you by. And if you can't come up with anything memorable, just make some shit up. We don't care. I don't have fact checkers working on this, so just whatever you want, just make it good. I mean, if it's true, it doesn't have to be good. If it's made up bullshit, then at least make it good. So again, bye everybody. It's October. We need to move Jeannie. Jeannie Zacher. She told us she's moving from Vancouver. In October. North Bay. To be near her son. And his new family. So we've updated it, but we'll put your old pin from where you used to be. Different color, so. Oops. Oh no. Don't go barefoot, guys. Holy. Yeah. Where is it? Oop, I felt it. It's over here somewhere. Help me look for it. I thought I felt it. So dangerous. Ooh, what's that? No, it's just garbage. Okay, I have to shake it out. found a seed bead. I have to keep that. Keep looking for that pin, though. I found it. Man, I just cleaned. This is so gross. This rug. We need a new vacuum cleaner. I heard something. What else can I find on the floor here? I know I heard one. Alright, well, whatever. Forgot where I was going with this. Oh, back in Vancouver. There we go. Okay. That's all I wanted to do.
That Jason guy was in the kitchen earlier when we came down for a snack. We scared him off. Don't mess with a hungry woman. A hungry woman who wants a smoke. Anyway, not a lot of content today, but hey, clearing off the memory on the phone. So, next up, probably the D-Pal. We'll do a tag paint along. For Alice. She's coming along nicely. Stay tuned.
So, if you go to bed before 8 and you lay there for hours not being able to fall asleep, do not tell me to drink warm milk. I'm not a fucking cat. Going for the scotch.